Welcome to Mastering Solutions. In this motion in two dimensions problem, they tell us that a car goes around a corner in a circular arc at a constant speed, and they want us to draw a motion diagram including positions, velocity vectors, and acceleration vectors. So in this problem, I've drawn an arc, and let's start by drawing all the positions, and we'll use these little black dots to represent it. So by going at a constant speed, all of the dots should be the exact same distance apart. I'll do my best to make them all the same distance. It's going to be a little off, but it'll be close enough to give us an idea. The constant speed, like I said, just means that the distance between these won't change at all. So now what we're going to do is draw the velocity vectors. I'm going to use different colors for all of the velocity vectors in between here because this can get a little bit confusing, and it will really help to illustrate what we're going to do here in just a moment. So from this very first one right here, we're going to say that the direction is going over the arc this way. So we're going to draw a straight line to represent the velocity vector for the first one. Now we'll do the same thing for all the others. Okay, so now we have all of the velocity vectors drawn for all of the positions. You can see that it's going at the same speed because the length of the velocity vectors are all the same. And if you remember that velocity is not scalar, meaning that the direction and the magnitude are both important. So even though the speed is the exact same, because it's changing direction as it goes around the arc, it is different velocity, meaning that there is some sort of acceleration with this. If we draw the acceleration formula, we know we've done this 1,000 times. It's a change in the velocity over the change in time. And whenever we have an equation like this and plug in numbers to it, it's pretty easy to conceptualize because we're so used to seeing it this way. We can break it up to v final minus v initial over t final minus t initial. And we've done this a ton of times, so you know this pretty well. Whenever we go to a picture, though, a lot of times it's really confusing for students because we're not used to seeing it represented this way, so it can be really confusing. So we're going to do the exact same thing here. We're going to take the final velocity and minus the initial velocity, and that will give us the acceleration vector. If you remember, whenever we subtract vectors, what we do is we take the one that we're subtracting from, in this case the initial velocity, and we flip it backwards, so we turn it upside down, and then we go tip to tail, and then we draw the resultant vector. So I drew the arrows all the different colors so you can see that I'm taking this one here, and now I'm going to draw it backwards. So here is this vector right there, and I just moved it up to this spot. It's backwards, and I took the tail of it and connected it to the tip of this one. So the pinkish vector, that one is our final velocity. The orange one is our initial velocity. And now we draw from the tail of the first one to the tip of the second one. So this gold arrow right here represents the acceleration vector. So you can see along the arc, the acceleration vector is going in. Let's do the same thing for all of these other ones. So we'll take this pink one and we'll take the exact same thing and we'll just turn it around backwards. And now the resultant acceleration is going in towards the center again. Do the same thing here. Okay, so here is the vectors and everything for this problem. The gold ones are representing the acceleration as we talked about. And so you can see when we're going in an arc, the acceleration is pointed towards the center. If you imagine this as a circle going all the way around, and we take the final velocity minus the initial, so the pink minus the orange, or the green minus the pink, etc. And that will give us a graphical representation of what the acceleration is. So this, as I said, is our completed picture here, or a graphical representation showing all of the position, velocity vectors, and acceleration vectors for a car going around a circular arc at a constant speed.